Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Roma Surrectum 2. Hasn't been very interactive the past few episodes because I've been taking obvious choices to defend our little empire here. I don't think there's going to be a lot of votes for, let's have Cytex of Atolibus just starve out all the people in Dyrrachium. That seems like a really good idea. So let's right click. There we go. And let's counterattack! Hooray! With Aulus Cornelius Mamula. Alright, I'll see you on the battle map. Okay, we are just kind of starting near the gate here. I'm gonna come out, and we're going to reorganize, and I'll get back to you once things are set up. Alright, I think this is a good point to record now, just to explain my strategy. I'm gonna try to use the wall here to protect my left flank. My main force is gonna have my slingers, my elite phalangists in the center to hold the center, flanked by cohorts. And then I have a couple skirmishers, and these guys I'm putting into reserve because I'm really going to be using them against all these phalangists. I have a light infantry contingent here who are all spearmen. They are going to be escorting my Acontisti and other missile infantry here, who have, and with a little bit of heavy infantry too, but they're the ones that are going to be trying to do a flank attack. And I'm going to have them move off to this side. And with cover this side, just try to do a bit of a pincer attack. My mistake last battle was not to have really anything protect my missile units, and they were very vulnerable to cavalry. So let's try not to make that same mistake again. And the enemy is maneuvering, so let me just group these guys up into two separate quadrants and get started. Let's move the bulk of the army here first. Let's do something like this. And then do something like this. Spearmen in these trees will be very beneficial. Now, he does have one missile unit here. These Greek Acontisti. However, we can outrange them with our missile units. What I really want to do, though, is use my Greek slingers to take out their cavalry and their not very well armored levy pikemen, because having them in melee is going to be pretty tricky. And they do have a lot of cavalry, and I'm not a big fan of it. Alright, still moving up. Let me just fast forward here a little bit. I could cut the edit, but I have a feeling something big will be happening soon. Now, my reinforcements haven't come because I'm using all my units. And it would be nice to have missile dominance completely, but I don't know if I want to waste my ammo on them. I might. I just might. Closer look at my brave men, the ones protecting mercenary and Roman and Greek alike, protecting dear Emporiae. Wait, no, not Emporiae, that's in Iberia. Dyrrachium, that's what I'm doing. Alright, now we're not within range, and you know what, we're gonna force them to come to us, I think. Because we do want to keep this protection on our left flank. Besides, we'll have our first move be this substantial group here. I think what we're going to try to do is attack them far on this side. If their infantry starts to turn around to the side to face my light flanking force, that's when I'll push forward, and I'll be able to attack them on two flanks, which is great. Defending is always fun, but it's funny. Me, as the aggressor, I have seized the initiative, so I get to determine where I want to attack. And what are you doing now? Just more maneuvers. Alright. Let's do something like this then. Let's move more to the left. And have you guys... I don't want to get married to this position here, though. So let's do something like this. Let's move closer. Inch closer towards victory. And I think I'm going to have these guys run. Yeah, Yeah, their peltasts are... Well, no, they don't know where to go. Well, are they moving forward? Yep, they are. Okay. Let's see here. You know what? I reckon my general can take care of them. Oh, what do we have here? General's guard is coming up. I need to get these guys more organized, like, now. So, pretty much stay where you are, guys. There. Run. Exception of you guys, I want you to withdraw. And then I might have to bring my own cavalry up to stop them from being charged, which I'm gonna have to do. Yep. Alright, go. Okay, let's just pause this for a second. Bring in the Sarissas while my general protects my slingers. How brave of him. And let's move them just here. I'll have plenty to do soon enough. And let's start on the Tarentine cavalry. Oh, and they are moving to our flank, so we're going to have to push forward. So first things first, we'll go have them go here, have my heavy troops go here, and my lighter troops, they can hurl javelins over their heads, like that. All right, have them all run, and we have to push upwards here. All right. Alright, General. You need to get out of the way now. Because pointy sticks are coming your way. There we go. Okay. Let's take our slingers and move them here. Take our infantry, move it here. I think we can take a few missiles. And let's take our skirmishers and move them here. There we go. Good job. Alright, that cavalry is going to be made short work of. Well, okay, what do we have going on here? Okay, taking out some of their cavalry. You guys attack theirs. Oh, this might be a mistake for them. Well, back and forth. I reckon a horse is easier to hit than a man, though. Yeah, no, they're broken. Excellent. Alright, let's bring the general up here. Start moving up my infantry. And have my missile units do what they do best, which is kill spearmen. Slow-moving spearmen. We are getting pummeled pretty badly with missile units, but we're giving it pretty well too.
Great gods be praised! The enemy general is killed.
We've killed the enemy general. Cytix of Bilius of Obilius. Excellent. Excellent. And now, just so things are a little bit more egalitarian, I think I'm gonna take my skirmishers, my two skirmishers. You can stay there. I'm going to move one unit over to here. I'm going to move one unit, this unit, over here. I'm going to have them just keep firing at will. We have a decent protection against enemy cavalry. And now if they're not going to make a move, we're pretty well protected. We're going to just, we're going to pummel these guys. Kill him with rocks. Okay, we gotta be careful here, though. Okay, no. We'll take my two cohorts, put them here. I need my pikemen to be in the center, though. Yeah, they've tried to reform. I wonder. Oh, here comes some of their cavalry. They're going after these guys.
Go, go, go!
Alright, managed to jam up some of their heavy cavalry. Oh no, our singers are getting hit, are gonna trying to be attacked by this Macedonian stuff.
Reinforcements have arrived.
Oh good, and our reinforcements have arrived. Things are not looking well for the enemy. Their general's dead. I can't imagine that would look very good for anybody. Alright, enough of that. Time to chase after these guys. You move to here. You guys move to here. You can skirmish now while you move to here. And we're gonna just keep your backs covered with my infantry here. How are we doing here? Pretty darn well. Okay. Alright, General Pants. You guys go here. You go here. You guys just get reformed here. Let's move up. Whoops. Time to just keep pressing this advantage. Alright, you know what? Yeah, you can stay on the side there. Alright. Time to pincer these guys in. And I still want to just have my slingers to keep. I mean, if I can attack them for as long as possible. Where are. There you all are. You know what? Let's just set you up right here, then. That'll be perfect. Except if these guys show up. We have a solution for that. Okay, no. Stay here. Their cavalry's trying to get behind us. Well, whoop-de-doo. We're gonna get behind your infantry, so yay for us. Fire at will. Well done, slingers. Oof. That can't be good. Uh-oh. No, 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 no. Actually, though. There we go. Yeah, their cavalry's just fleeing. And alas, their infantry doesn't have much more of a choice. Although I wouldn't mind organizing you guys a little bit better. What can I say? I'm a stickler for organization, and they still refuse to attack us. Which is great. Yeah, now they're just a big hump of sticks and men. Fantastic. Alright, you know what? You guys... You never know, something could happen. Where did their cavalry fled? Oh my god, what a bunch of cowards. Oh, now they're fleeing. Yay! More cowards for everyone, I think. These guys seem disorganized. Attack them. Their levies, too. Yeah. Don't make them live. Don't make them live. AKA kill them? I'm the best general in the world. Oh yeah, panic is gonna spread now. They're boned. Actually, these guys should go up here to cut off retreat. So my slingers are still doing a gosh darn good job. Ooh, yeah, those are the guys you want to attack. They seem a little bit more prepared than simple levies. Yep. Oh, don't get too eager though. Don't go running into those spiky pits of doom. If anything, kill these little shaken guys. Yeah, you guys skirmish. Oh yeah, they're trying to flee. Alright, well I think we got this one pretty much in the bag. I have to, get my slingers over here, though. And I might not be able to catch these guys, but they're just levy pikemen. They are almost not worth. But you know what? Let's throw in my elite phalangists here. And these guys. And these guys who I've been keeping on reserve. And these guys. And our gear. Okay, you guys need to get out of the way. You guys need to get over here. There we go. Alright, we broke them. And I reckon if we kill these guys, we should be okay. So actually, I want you guys to all disengage and have my slingers do most of the work there. Yeah, but they're a disorganized heap now. I'll kill them piecemeal, and I'll get back to you. Well, that was a clear victory. We have, yeah, well, as that guy croons on. We had very few casualties, and we inflicted quite a few kills. Took out, what was the percentage? 63% of their force. And all they really have left is pretty much light cavalry and some levy phalanx troops. About 4 units of phalanx managed to escape. They just became so dispersed I wasn't able to chase them down with my foot troops. So, that's that, but, definitely inflicted a lot of casualties, once again, with my slingers being the MVPs, so I will see you back on the campaign map. Alright, so that's one dead general and another defeated army, which is fantastic. So I'm going to just reorganize, my, garrison, and I will be right back. Okay, so now I have a decent force here at Dyrrachium, a big chunk of infantry, which I think is very important for defending a city. I still have my slingers, a few skirmishers, some light infantry in case we have to go outside the walls again. I do have some leftovers here, though, and I could disband them, but I have a feeling there's going to be a lot of fighting going on around Dyrrachium with both Greece and the Macedonians as my enemies, so I'm actually going to put them on this ship. And that way they can't get attacked by themselves, but they can disembark and help out with any sort of fight. I also have more reinforcements coming in here from General Publius. So that's that. I am going to... Now, I think that's it for all the fighting. Pretty sure that is, actually, now that I think about it. We don't see any more men coming over here. It'd be nice to start... take these cities, but our army is really going to deal with Syracuse. I'd actually kind of want to take Syracuse first. That way I have a united Sicily too, and that's another, you know, possible problem that will be shored up. So, here's hoping. Usually, since it's kind of dull, I'm just going to go through all the building and whatnot. First, let's just quickly go with our agents. I still have this spy out here in Genoa, because we have a Carthaginian spy, and we want to keep him there. We have our diplomat in Dyrrachium. Let's talk with the Macedonians, see if they want to talk about anything. Maybe a ceasefire, maybe a... Nope, they don't want to have anything. Once we're done taking Syracuse, perhaps we'll talk with the Macedonians. We have a spy here. Which is important, because we did see, I could have swore, I saw an army. Secrecy is assured. Yeah, kicking around here. That they were moving past. I think, secrecy, yes, this is who I want to keep an eye on, because I think this army here is going to try to take back Carthage. We can handle it, but... we want to have our spy just keep an eye on him and see which direction he's going to go. In fact, let's just scout out ahead of him where we assume he is going to go, and that way, yeah, see, like, he's either going to go here, here, or here, and we'll be able to keep an eye on him if he's going in that direction. If he disappears, it means he's going in the other direction, and we don't have to worry about him just yet. We want to keep our spy here in Dyrrachium because we have Macedonian assassins coming after us. And speaking of assassins, we might as well try to train this one up by having him attack the militia barracks. And now he's dead. That was a giant waste of money. Appius, Minius, Lantus, we're putting you in, like, his head, and whatever. I set him up to fail. A 20% chance, it's not very good. But what else was I going to do with them, right? Alright, so I'll get to recruiting and building building buildings, and I'll get back to you. Well, before we do anything else, let's take a little revenge on these damn Greeks and attack with our navy. And crush them. Good. Excellent. And let's just bring these guys back so they can be retrained in Messana. Good. That's about it, I think, navy-wise. Although I do have an army. Oh, good. I do have those men coming there. I still don't know exactly where to put them. There seems to make the most sense, but I might need them over here. We'll see what the next turn has to... tell us. Some pirates here, but I can't really quite deal with them yet, or at least I'm not comfortable in doing so. Nor am I comfortable ferrying these guys over. One, two, three. I'm not so sure about that. Let's get another boat there. Okay. I'll be right back. Alright, other than a few temples that I'm building, the only other thing of note is Arretium is getting itself a nice little wine trade in small vineyards, so that will increase our income by a good 500 or so, approximately 500 denarii a turn, which is nothing to shake a stick at, because we have pretty much no trade. We only trade with the boy, because anyone else within trade that can create trade lanes other than ourselves is at war with us. So, there goes that. Alright, I'll see you at next turn. And almost like they could hear me, the Galaci are offering us trade rights. Unfortunately, Galaci, the only town that is near you, is going to fall soon. So we're going to just give them a counter offer and just give them some money just to kind of keep us in consideration and give that to them as a gift. And that's it. Alright, the Greek city-states are the most advanced nation now. That's no good. A client state ruler for Publius Cornelius Scipio. Yes, he is. Which is fine, because it looks like... Yep, he's been accepted as the ruler without penalty. Excellent, which means we should be able to... Yes, our client state barracks will soon come up. That's great. Anything else of note? Construction report? Blah, 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 blah. And our recruitment report, pretty important. Let's just go ahead and get these guys out here too. Yeah, alright. Still not 100% sure where to send these men, but I'm sure I'll be able to figure it out. I'm gonna be making a move and that will kind of determine what happens. In fact, Pergamon and Macedon are no longer at war anymore. Great, they can focus their attention on me. We have a Greek diplomat kicking around here. But I want to get some blood for the near defeat that I suffered by Agrica. So I think I'm going to do it. Now, I have a war machine here, and I am hoping against hope that we can use it to batter down the walls of Syracuse and attack them right away. But before I do so, I am going to stop recording, save the game, and reorganize this a little bit, because I want to incorporate some of these forces with this and kind of just make a nice, strong front in case I do have to attack them right away. So I'll be right back. All right, so I've cleaned this up a little bit. I've merged some of my units, my Allied Republican cohorts, so they are full, as are my plebeians. My Triarii are still a little beat up. I have 4 missile units, a few skirmishers, because that's all I really had left as far as full units go. So these are kind of my backup, but let's see if this is going to work. Let's see if my war machine will let me assault, and it will. All right, so here's hoping this will work, because I don't want to give them a turn, because then the garrison script will fire up, which means they'll be able to mobilize a garrison to defend Syracuse. But if we do this quick attack, we should be okay. So I will see you on the battle map. Holy crap, look at the walls of Syracuse. Can't wait to take this place. Wow, with a pantheon and everything. Oh, Hero, that's the enemy general. He was such a fool to attack us. He probably thought, well, we'll get one over on the Romans. Well, now here we are, and we're gonna take a city. Oh, well. Alright, I had a bit of a glitch, unfortunately. Well, an error or something. I loaded up the map, and I started to smash things, and unfortunately, I had a crashed desktop. So, unfortunately, what I'm going to do, I don't want to go through all that again. It was probably just a glitch with the ballistae attacking the iron gates or something like that. So, what I'm going to do is just kind of show what the city looked like, and then I'm just going to splice in this and cut out the other footage that would make no sense because then it crashed. So we're just going to auto-resolve this battle. It's 5-1. Hero had no chance anyway. So let's automatically resolve. We have a clear victory. He killed a whole lot of my men though. But you know what? I'll take that as a payment for not actually doing it myself. So I guess that's that. Now, the question is, what do we do with these damn Greeks? Do we just occupy the settlement, do we enslave them, or do we depopulate them? The Greeks were our allies for a long time. They betrayed... I wish I could leave this up to a vote, but it's too late now. No, you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna leave this up to a vote. So, for those of you, I'm going to just end the series of video here, and what I can do is I can just load up my previous save right when I was about to auto-resolve, and no big deal. Alright, so, what should we do with these Greeks? Should we just occupy the settlement? Should we enslave them? Or should we depopulate them? AKA, execute a whole bunch of them. I look forward to your responses, and I'll catch you again next time.